crazy, right? My hair. So if you guys don't follow me on Instagram, you guys haven't seen my new color. And yeah, I got a lot of color. It's very bright. I'm still getting used to it. And I really want you guys' opinion on what you guys think. I'm still kind of debating on whether I like it, but I kind of do. You know, it's different. I've never had my hair this light before. I guess at least this much lightness. Yeah, so it's definitely different for me. But I just want to come on here and show you guys in full circle kind of what it looks like and all of that stuff, so you guys can really get a full view of what my hair is looking like. So let's talk about that. Let's talk about, you know, my hair and the condition that it's in since I've colored it. You know, I'm not gonna lie, I have suffered from color damage, chemical damage from the color. And so right now my hair is in a roller set. Well, I did a roller set, which I haven't done one of these in like years. So this is my first time doing one in a long time. So if you guys wanna know how I achieved, how I got this, let me know and I'll do a tutorial. And this was on just curly hair, like damp hair, washed fresh hair. I didn't straighten it or blow it out before or anything like that. But yeah, it actually came out a lot better than I thought it would, honestly. I thought it was about to be a disaster. So yeah, let me know if you guys want to see the tutorial how to get this hair. So yeah, so I did suffer from some heat damage. So heat, why do I keep saying heat? Coloring, I guess chemical damage from the bleach and everything. But let me talk about the color and everything like that first. So my sister actually did it for me. I didn't get it professionally done or anything like that. And she just used the Blue Magic or Quick Blue bleach that she gets from Sally's. And then she, to actually strip my hair first to bleach it. And then she mixed like a toner and a color, box color from Ion, together to get the actual color of what it is. Honestly, whenever I initially bleached it, it was basically this color, but it was a little bit more orange. So basically we toned it that down to make it look like this, more of a really, really dark golden, light brown slash blonde slash copper. I don't know what you want to call it, but whatever this color is, that's what we came up with. And honestly, I wish I could tell you the color that she used in toner, but honestly I don't know. And I asked her, I was like, where's the packaging so I could tell people, because I know I'm gonna get asked. And she threw it away. So I was like, I'm not digging in the trash. I'm not that real. I'm sorry, I'm not that real. But if I can find something similar or whatever, I'll definitely let you guys know when it comes, I guess, if I want to touch it up or whatever. But I will go ahead and include some pictures either right now or at the end of kind of the process of how she did it. And I posted a couple pictures on Instagram, kind of like a, you know, a two thing in one, but I'll show more in here, kind of like what it looked like, you know, throughout the process and things like that. It was very scary, I will say, because my hair got really, really light in some parts and I was just like, whoa, okay. But I was like, you know what? Go hard or go home, right? So I was just like, okay, let's do it. So yeah, and right now the way I'm going to be just combating the damage at this point is doing a lot of protective styling. So really my protective style is buns. I do a lot of buns and like head wraps and things like that. And then just a lot of deep conditioning. I did a protein treatment straight after I colored my hair, and it was a homemade one. So it had like honey, Greek yogurt, olive oil, coconut oil, jojoba oil, and coconut milk. And I just mixed all that up and put it all over my hair. I left it on for about 30 minutes, then had the blow dryer on it for about 10 minutes to let it kind of like really sink in there. And then I washed that out. And then last night, because I did it two nights ago, last night I went to sleep with just some random conditioner and a bunch of olive oil, and I just kept it in there overnight. So I'm just definitely trying to kind of pump up my moisture and life back into my hair, because it is, you know, it has suffered. You know, you're not gonna color your hair and go through no damage. Like, and I did, you know, I really weird light, so I knew I was gonna go through some heat damage, some color damage. But you know, I feel like everything is a lesson, everything is a testimony. And you know, I get a lot of girls on here, or guys, you know, asking me, you know, how to recover from damage and things like that, coloring and heat styling and everything like that. So hey, we're gonna go through this journey together, and I'm gonna rediscover things that I used to use, because I haven't really had to deal with color damage or heat damage in a long time. So seriously, kind of like on the level that I'm at right now, so I can kind of revisit some things and kind of discover new things that'll hopefully be helpful for you all as well. And that is kind of like my goal at this point, is like, ooh, I have a new thing to kind of go through with you guys with. So yeah, if you guys are coloring your hair or anything like that, think about coloring it, definitely stay tuned. I'll probably put up more videos about, you know, kind of like my recovery process and things like that, and getting my hair back to where it was. Honestly, I know a lot of people are kind of like, why did you do that? You know, your curls are so perfect, blah, blah, blah. You know, I'm the kind of person, like, I really reached, like, my optimum, like, curl length status. Like, you know, I really hit what exactly where I wanted to be curl-wise and length-wise. I did. And so I got bored. I was like, okay, well, I need a new challenge now. And so now, I want to do something different. And you know, I've had my hair the same way for a long time, and I wanted something different, so there you go. And yeah, so I thought color would be cool and something I could explore. And I'm young, you know, hair, it's just hair. It'll grow back, it'll come back, I can nurse it back to life. You know, I love taking care of my hair, so it's not that I'm scared that, you know, it's gonna just fall out. I know it's not, because I know too much about my hair, too much about what it takes to really bring it back to health, to let it fall apart. So from this point on, it's only up, and I'm excited about, you know, trying out new things with my new color. Definitely this, I really, really like the way this looks. My hair doesn't curl up as much as it used to, but I'm not really worried about that. Again, it's a challenge, it's something to experience, and I'm not really tripping about the fact that my hair isn't curling as much as it did before. Now, if I had to cut off, like, all of this hair off and go short, I would do it. Like, I'm very open to different hairstyles and things like that, so I feel like my hair is very versatile, so I can do that. So yeah, definitely, since I'm dealing with the color and everything like that, I'm definitely gonna be on my deep condition grind for real. Definitely doing that once a week at least, and wearing my hair curly all the time. I mean, this is probably the most processed it's gonna get. And this is a roller set on curly hair, and all I did was sit under a dryer. So that isn't really a big deal heat-wise. And of course, I'm using protectants and good products and everything, so it's not really hurting my hair at this point. But this is kind of like what my go-to style will probably start being like, since I'm not gonna be straightening it and flat ironing and all that kind of stuff. Especially it's summer, or it's about to be summer, springtime, so I don't straighten my hair that much in the heat anyway, because it's just too much. So yeah, but if you guys have questions about the color of my hair, how I'm dealing with it, anything like that, stay tuned on Instagram for sure. I always post up on there. It's quicker than YouTube. And yeah, until next time, I'll talk to you guys later.